This time of year is ripe for reviewing your life, what's working, what's not working, and then using that information to plan your best year yet. In this video, I am looking at something that claims to help you do just that, Your Best Year 2018 by Lisa Jacobs. Is it worth parting with your hard-earned money? Let's go. Hi guys, it's Laura from How to Get Your Shit Together, and I help you get organized, get motivated, and have your best year yet. And that last one is something Lisa Jacobs is trying to do too. This is the new 2018 version of the Your Best Year workbook, and it actually comes in two editions this year, the Life Edition and the Business Edition. For the purposes of this review, I will be sticking with the Life Edition. So what I'm going to do is flip you around and skim through the book for you, give you a look at the inside, let you know kind of what to expect from it. I will point out some exercises that I found particularly helpful, and then I will pop back and sum up my thoughts and let you know whether or not I think this is worth purchasing. So this is it. It is a soft cover, kind of almost magazine style workbook. And this is the Life Edition. And then, as I said, there is a Business Edition too. I have gone through both and there isn't a huge difference between the two of them. A lot of the exercises are the same, though obviously there are some additional kind of business related ones in this. You just answer them as they pertain to your professional life as opposed to your personal life. So let's stick with the Life Edition. So it starts with kind of an explainer on best practices for using the workbook, how to get the most out of it, and some suggestions for tools you might use, and why it's so important to set goals, and how the book is laid out, and kind of just generally what to expect. After that, then, there is a discussion on how to be one of the small minority who actually achieves their goals. It all starts with action. So here on page 17 is the first exercise. It's about making firm decisions and following through on them. And then once you've got that clear on your head, in your head, it moves on to the State of the Union. So an honest assessment of where you currently are. And then, of course, there are exercises to help you figure it out. Now, throughout most of the workbook, you will see that the actual exercises are on the left-hand side. And then on the right, there are some sample answers. Now, personally, I found the sample answers to be a little bit distracting and I try to avoid looking at them. Does anyone else remember in school when some of the maths books had the answers in the back? And you can never help having a quick look. But really, that doesn't improve the learning experience. Now obviously I know Lisa's answers are going to be different to mine, but I wanted to really kind of wrestle with the exercises and get the most out of them and force my brain to really examine things rather than just kind of glancing across and being all, oh yeah, I'll put that down too. Does that make sense? So because there was actually one exercise where I accidentally glanced at an answer of Lisa's and I thought, oh yes, that's what I'd like to do too, and I ended up running with her answer rather than trying to critically evaluate what would work best for me. Now, I know sometimes people can get stuck on an exercise or maybe not fully understand what the question means or what they're supposed to be doing. So I suppose that's why Lisa put these in. But personally, I feel like a quick explainer would have sufficed. Anyway, there are several exercises, as you've seen, to help you evaluate what's working and what's not working in your life. And then there is one for prioritizing and better managing your time. After that, then, it goes on to kind of what's holding you back, why you're not seeing the results you want, you know, what are you doing instead? So this was a real eye-opener for me because rather than just looking at why I wasn't achieving my goal and giving myself all sorts of excuses, it forced me to face up to kind of the negative behaviors and habits I have and to realize that those were the reason I wasn't achieving my goal. You know, not that I didn't have enough time or enough money or enough self-control. It's because I was doing crap like scrolling through social media half the evening. So I particularly liked this question on page 32. Approximately how long would you need to forgo the above activities and replace them with a better habit before you would see results? And because it made me quantify my goal. So instead of feeling overwhelmed by it or complaining that it would take too long, I had to put a number on it. I had to be honest about how little effort in the grand scheme of things it would really take. And I think when you quantify something in, you know, minutes, hours, days, etc., suddenly the goal seems much more tangible and achievable. So I found that particularly helpful. Just in case you're wondering, I actually used this notebook here to fill out the exercises. So I wanted the book kind of pristine so that I could show you. Also just because I'm a perfectionist and I hate marking up books. But yes, I used a separate notebook. So those are some extra exercises there then. After that, the book talks about facing up to fears, identifying what you're afraid of and learning how to break through that. I really love this exercise on page 39, the "if I knew I could not fail" exercise, because when I write down the things I would love to do but I'm not doing, it's very obvious that fear is what's stopping me from doing them. I might not always be aware of that fear or know why I feel it, but just knowing that it's fear of something, it starts me thinking and examining and asking questions and trying to get to the root of the problem. So yeah, some real soul searching stuff there. After that, it talks about endurance, so what it's going to take to get you moving. So there are some exercises on kind of surveying your current situation, how you're currently equipped, you know, what you need to keep in mind if you want to go the extra mile, and the vision that you have for your life. And then you break those down into five key areas, so financial, spiritual, mental, physical, and relational. And there is talk about the importance of visualization, the benefits of envisioning what you want your life to look like, and then an exercise to help get it clear in your mind. There's also a section on your why, so the real reason you want to do what you're aiming for, the thing that will keep you moving even when you just don't feel like it. Rewards also keep you moving. So there's a question here about what ridiculously extravagant gift you'll reward yourself with if you achieve your vision. Again, just something kind of to spur you on. So next then is the forward planning and strategizing section. So how exactly you're going to get from A to B, what you'll need to do and when. And then before we get into the final section of the book, there is a discussion about kind of who you want to become, and what you need to do in order to become that person. And the biggest eye-opener for me, I think, was this question on page 68. So what are the discrepancies between what you want and the actions you take? That really forced me to face up to the fact that my actions don't always match my words. I might say I want to spend less time on social media, but the first thing I do when I have a spare minute or when I get distracted is reach for my phone. So what are the areas in your life where you're just kind of talking the talk but not walking the walk? And now that you've got your objectives for the year, it is time to start planning and doing. So you write your list of all of the things that you want to do, all of the things that you need to achieve in the first quarter, and it goes through each quarter. And then as you progress, you move them to the appropriate section. So are they finished? Are they a work in progress? Is it something that you're celebrating? Is it something you need to research or to learn a bit more about? Or is there something you need to start doing? After that, you break it all down so that you can see at a glance in any given month what you need to be doing. You write down your open tasks, the tasks you've completed or that no longer need to be done, and then anything new that crops up during the month. And then on the next page then you set your intention for the month. So what you're going to focus on in each area of your life, what your vision for the month is, and how you're going to turn it into a reality. And then finally you've got your weekly review where you list what you've achieved, what helped you along the way, what held you back, and what you need to change. Over on this side, you've also got a daily scorecard. So each circle represents 25%. So kind of depending on how you feel you did each day, how much effort and energy you put into achieving your goals, you score yourself by filling in the circles. And that way then you can track and measure your performance. So there is a spread for each quarter, each month, and each week. And that is how most of the rest of it goes. But then finally, at the end, there is a short section just here on setbacks. Because We all experience them. Just some tips on how to overcome them, as well as next over here, there is a recommendation list if you want some kind of additional inspirational sources. And then that is it. That is everything. So what do I really think of the workbook, and do I think it is worth parting with your hard-earned cash? Honestly, there were parts of this workbook that I found incredibly helpful, like the exercises I mentioned about facing up to your fears and also noticing the difference between what I say I want to do and what I'm actually doing on a day-to-day basis. I also like that it stays with you throughout the year. So some other books, you do the exercises once and then you're done with it. Whereas the quarterly logs and the monthly spread and the weekly reviews in this will probably keep you coming back to it. But I didn't find it very strong on practical advice, like how to break down your goals or any tips in there on, you know, for example, how best to manage your time. Now, maybe that was a very conscious decision on Lisa's part. Maybe she wanted to stick to the more kind of abstract side of things, you know, just setting intentions and visualizing the outcomes and just getting you started on the right foot and then giving you a list of kind of extra resources that you could study if you wanted to. I don't know. For me, it was an almost complete system. I found it more motivational and thought-provoking than truly practical. So, would I recommend it? I would say if you have already done a review of the past year and you have a reasonably good grasp of where you're at and where you want to be, and you're looking for practical tips on how to help you get there, this probably is not the workbook for you. If, on the other hand, you are struggling to set goals or to really evaluate your life, if you just don't really know where to start or you find it all a bit overwhelming and you're looking for something to take you through the process step by step, something to give you a bit of a boost, then this is definitely worth a go. It is very well laid out. It asks some really great questions and you will definitely have a clearer picture of your life by the end of it. So if you really want to sit down and do a serious reevaluation of things and you have a decent chunk of time, it took me almost 2 days, 2 solid days to go through this, so I would clear a weekend, and you have some spare cash, then yes, I would say this is definitely worth the $15 odd I paid for it. I will pop a link in the description box below to where you can buy it on Amazon if you want to purchase it, or maybe if you just wanted to go and take a look at the reviews over there. Please give this video a thumbs up if you feel that you could do with a little bit of a life reset. And comment below and let me know what is the one thing you would do if you knew you could not fail. If you're looking for more ways to help you get your shit together and you haven't already done so, then subscribe to the channel because I upload new videos every Thursday to help you live a simpler, happier life. Until next time, I hope your 2018 is as bright as my jumper. Karev Mila Magav. Agus Vekimishiv Shigalua. Slán.